Hello friends, you are welcome to my YouTube channel MacPM. So in this video we will solve another problem on the deflection of beams. So this is a cantilever beam of length 2.5 meter. It carries a uniformly distributed load of 16.4 kN per meter length over the entire length. If the moment of inertia of the beam is 7.95 into 10 to the power 7 mm to the power 4 and value of E is 2 into 10 to the power 5 newton per mm square, determine the deflection at free end. So we have to find the deflection here. So suppose that we don't have any formula for this. So first of all we will derive formula for the general case, then we will put all the values in that formula to get the deflection. So suppose beam will deflect like this, and this is y, we have to get deflection, and this is theta b, slope is theta. Okay, now we have boundary condition. At suppose this is at x distance, we are choosing a section xx at x distance from the right hand, right? So at x is equal to l, at this point y will be 0, and at x is equal to l, dy by dx will be 0, because this end is fixed, so there will be no deflection here, and slope will be also 0. Okay, so now let's solve. What will be the movement due to this uniformly distributed load w unit per length? So if weight is w here, then we will have movement due to this load w into x is load, and distance of the centroid of this section is x by 2 from this section. So moment will be wx square by 2, and it is a Hawking moment, so it will be minus. Now we have ei d square y upon dx square is equal to minus wx square upon 2. So we can write, because this is also moment and this is also bending moment, so we can write d, if we integrate this once, then we will get ei dy upon dx is equal to minus wx cube x power cube divided by 6 plus c1 is a constant. So if we put, this is equation number 1, if we put the value of dy by dx is equal to 0 at x is equal to at l, then we will get ei into 0 is equal to minus w l cube by 6 plus c1. So we will get c1 is equal to w l cube by 6. So if we put the value of c1 in equation number 1, then we will get ei dy by dx is equal to minus w x cube by 6 plus w l cube by 6. So this is equation number 1a. Now if we again do integration in this equation, then we will get ei into y is equal to minus w x to the power 4 divided by 24 plus w l cube power 6 l power cube divided by 6 x plus c2. If we put at x is equal to l, y is equal to 0 from this boundary condition, then we will get 0 is equal to, this is equation number 2, 0 is equal to minus w l to the power 4 divided by 24 plus w l to the power 4 divided by 6 plus c2. So from here we will get, this is 24, 3 w l to the power 4 divided by 24 plus c2 is equal to 0, so we will get c2 is equal to minus w l to the power 4 divided by 8. Okay, so we will put the value of c2 in equation number 2, so we will get e I y is equal to minus w x to the power 4 divided by 24 plus w l cube by 6 into x minus w l to the power 4 divided by 8. So this is equation number 1b. This is for slope and this is for deflection. Now we know that we have to find the slope at liquefaction at the free end. So at free end we can see that at free end x is equal to 0. So theta from this equation number 1a, if we put x is equal to 0, then we will get EI dy by dx is equal to WL cube by 6. So we can find dy by dx is equal to theta is equal to WL cube by 6 EI. Okay, this is the equation for slope. Now we will find another equation for deflection. So for deflection it is EIY from this equation 1b is equal to, this will become 0, this will become 0, and this will become minus WL to the power 4 divided by 8. So y is equal to minus WL to the power 4 divided by 8 EI. So this is equation for the deflection. So in question we have been given L is equal to 2.5 meter and W is 60.4 kilonewton per meter. If the moment of inertia I is given as 7.95 into 10 to the power 7 mm to the power 4 and E is given as 2 into 10 to the power 5. Okay, this is in newton per mm square. So first of all we have to make the unit same, so it is in mm, it is also in mm, so we have to make L is equal to 2.5 into 10 to the power 3 mm and W is equal to, it is in newton, so we will also convert this into newton, 16.4 into 10 to the power 3, this is newton divided by 1000 mm. So we will get 16.4 kilo and newton per mm. Now you can see that in problem it is asked only to define the deflection at the free end. So we have formula y is equal to minus WL cube upon 8 EI. So it will become minus W is 16.4 into L is 2.5 into 10 to the power 3 into cube upon 8 into E is 2 into 10 to the power 5 into I is 7.95 into 10 to the power 7. Okay, so if you put all the values, if you calculate, then you will get Y is equal to minus 5.036 mm. Minus means it is downward deflection. So it is our answer. I hope you understand this problem. If you have any doubt, then please ask in comment section. And if you like this video, then please share and subscribe my channel. And thanks for watching this video.